In 1963, Asa Phillip Randolph's opening remarks were, "We here today are only the first wave. When we leave, it will be to carry on the civil rights revolution back home, into every nook and every cranny of this land." Hello, Freedom Family. I'm Clayola Brown, the president of the A. Phillip Randolph Institute. Here we are, 50 years later, the second wave, standing ready to carry on the revolution, standing ready to fight for jobs and for freedom, standing ready to advance the struggle for shared prosperity and equality for all of God's children. This is our charge. Dr. King said, "Human progress is neither automatic nor inevitable. Every step towards the goal of justice requires sacrifice, suffering, and struggle." And I know you've heard it before, but I'm going to say it again because it comes from our founder, Asa Phillip Randolph, that at the banquet table of nature, there are no reserve seats. You get what you can take, and you keep what you can hold. If you can't take anything, you won't get anything. And if you can't hold anything, you won't keep anything. And you can't take anything without organization. We must organize. We must organize. We must organize.
Good afternoon. I'm so proud to represent the 1.6 million members of the American Federation of State, County, and Municipal Employees, AFSCME, public service workers whose labor touches communities throughout this nation. You know, AFSCME stood with Dr. King in 1963 when he called on America to be true to its principles. And 5 years later, Dr. King stood with AFSCME when the sanitation workers of Local 1733 demanded justice, dignity, and respect. The journey for civil rights, workers' rights, and economic rights began almost from the moment America was born. It gained new momentum on these steps 50 years ago, and it advances whenever the disenfranchised and disillusioned stand up, fight back, and march forward. Because our struggle continues, we come to this memorial not only to commemorate the past, but to shape the future. We have the power to carry the determination, the hope, and passion of the March on Washington forward. We must also have the courage. We must also have the courage. In the name of Dr. King, A. Phillip Randolph, Bayard Rustin, Dorothy Height, Ella Baker, and Congressman John Lewis, on behalf of those whose names will never be known, we must recommit to the struggle. As stewards of a nation that belongs to the rich and the poor, to the CEO and the sanitation worker, those with and those without, we have the responsibility to build on the legacy that has been left to us all. We must protect the most fundamental rights we have, the right to vote. We must ensure that workers' voices will never be silenced. We must fight for good jobs and decent pay. And we must become a just and fair society of our ideals. Above all, we must uphold the principle that everyone who contributes to the prosperity of this nation should share in the prosperity of our nation. Thank you.